Hello students,
in this video we will see what is hypocycloid and how to draw hypocycloid. So hypocycloid is a locus of point on circumference of rolling circle which rolls without slipping inside another circle. In epicycloid, rolling circle rolls outside directing circle, and in a hypocycloid rolling circle rolls inside directing circle. So first of all, it is given that the rolling circle diameter as 50 mm in numerical, and a circle of 50 mm diameter rolls on circumference of another circle of 150 mm diameter. The numerical is same as in epicycloid. Only change is that in epicycloid it is given that rolling circle rolls outside directing circle, and in hypocycloid it rolls inside it. Trace the locus of point on circumference of rolling circle for one complete revolution. Draw normal and tangent at any point on the curve. First of all, rolling circle diameter is 50 mm, so radius as 25 mm. Then directing circle diameter 150 mm, so capital R is 75 mm, and angle we can calculate as we have calculated in epicycloid. So angle POA is equals to 360 into small r upon capital R. So 360 into 25 upon 75. So angle is same 120 degree as we have calculated in epicycloid. So first of all, take radius as 75 mm and draw an arc . Now give the center point of this arc as name point O. Then join this O point to the arc and give name to this point as point P. Now hypocycloid, in which rolling circle is inside the circle. Rolling circle is inside the curve. So take radius of 25 mm and center point is this point C, and draw a rolling circle inside the arc PA. Center point is C, and draw a rolling circle . Then next task is angle POA is 120 degree, so draw, this is PO and A point is here, so draw angle POA as 120 degree degrees here. So I will join O point to this point, so the point obtained is A point. So angle POA is 120 degree. Next, divide this rolling circle into 12 equal parts. So for that, first I will draw a arc from point C. Then divide this circle into 12 equal parts. So angle is 30 degree, 30, 60, 90, 120, 150. Then join all these points to point C. And give name to this point as this is point 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and at point P there is a point 12. Now next task is divide angle POA into 12 equal parts. So each part will appear as 10 degree. So take 10 degree angle. So 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 110, then 120. Now give name to all these center points as C1, C2, C3, C4 up to C12. Then next task is draw the arcs through various points on the circle, that is from point 11 and point 1. Draw the arc. Then next, draw arc from point 10 and 2. Then from point 9 and 3. Then from point 8 and 4. Then from point 7 and 5. And last from point 6. Now next task is take 25 mm distance in your rounder and center points as C1, C2, C3 up to C12 and draw arcs passing through these point arcs. So take center point as C1 and mark a arc on this one line. On this line, so this is point 1. Then take center point C2 and draw arc on this curve passing through point 2. Then take center point as C3 and mark the arc. Then C4 and on fourth line. Then C5 5 line. Then C6 on 6th line. Then C7 on 7th line. C8 on 8th line. C9 on 9th line. So 9th line means 9 and 3 lines. So this is the line. Then C10. Then C11. On 11th line. And C12 on end point. C11 on 11th curve. So we have got all the points. Now join all these points with the help of a French curve. So the curve will start from P and end up to A. So join P to point 1, then next point 3, and the third line, so this is point 3, then to point 4, so curve on the point 4 is this point, so join this point too. Then C5, join curve to point 5. So we join these points. C5, then to C6. Join up to this point. Join all these points by a smooth curve. So I have completed this curve of hypocycloid, and keep this arc PA as dark. So this is the epicycloidal curve. Now how to draw normal and tangent to the epicycloid? So first, take any point, say this point as point M on the curve and take radius of 25 mm from point M. So from point M, take radius 25 mm and mark a arc on this line. So this is point. So join this point, say name, give name to this point as point Q. So join OQ line. Now this OQ line touches the arc PA to this point. Give name to this point as point N. So MN is the normal. MN is the normal to hypocycloid. Now take perpendicular to the MN line, so it is tangent to the curve and give name to this tangent as ST. So ST is the tangent of hypocycloid. In this way we have completed hypocycloid, normal and tangent.